Hi world, this is Pastor Dr. Esther Basike saying in our own language in Kenya, Jambo, Jambo, Jambo. Hello world. This is our Keep It Real show where we keep it real using our life stories to inspire the world. This is just a preamble of what you should be expecting that will be taking place on Sunday, the 1st of November, 8 p.m. East African time. Right now, we just want to give you just a little gist of what you should be expecting. And I want you to share this. I've seen some of you already live with us. I want you to share this. Make sure you let everybody know that there is a way to the top. There is a way to the top. If I can borrow the word of Mr. Enang, the day we hosted him, he said, it is not that there are no jobs, that people are saying there are no jobs. He said, there are jobs, that we don't have faithful men and women. That's what he said. He said, we don't have faithful men and women to do the job, but there are jobs. So we want to borrow from where we left it some time back and to bring it on board right now to say that there is a ladder that you can use to climb to the top in life. And I have said, don't be satisfied with where you are currently, because where you are is crowded. It's crowded on this level. There are so many people there, and that's why everyone is stepping on each other. I want you to come up a bit and see that there's a lot of space up there, a lot of space up there. And so we don't need to be crowded here and, stepping on each other. We need to get up somewhere. But how do you get up there? That's why we keep it real show. So, ladies and gentlemen, on the show today, just the preamble, we have a man of integrity, a man of character, a man of excellence. I am borrowing from the words that some of you have used to describe him when you heard that he will be on show on Sunday. He says he's a man of character, a man of excellence, a man of integrity. And I can affirm it because I have known this man for a number of years. So I am talking about no other fellow but Mr. Kevin Balogun, Senior Partner, Veraki Africa. I want you to just welcome him with, how we do it. We normally do a standing ovation. There's nothing like a clapping ovation, but I have innovated a word called clapping ovation. So wherever you are, give him a clapping ovation. Give him a clapping ovation. And help me to share this massively. Let people know that we still have a remnant in Africa, and Africa can still be better than what it is. Mr. Balogo, over to you. You are welcome. I know that you are preparing for us for Sunday, but just allow us to get to know who you are, and in just few sentences, what should people expect from you on Sunday? Over to you, sir.
Good evening, good afternoon, good morning, wherever you are in the world, the fans of Keeping It Real show. I've heard a lot about the program. I feel truly privileged to be the next guest on the program. My name, as Pastor Obaseke introduced, is Kelvin Balogun. I'm currently a senior partner and co-founder in a consulting technology company called Veraki Africa. Look, I want to come and share my life story, but I'm hoping thematically to leave you with a sense about what it is to live on the basis of values, a values-based life, a character-based life. Character-based lives get so much bad press these days. People think, oh, you're just hamstringing yourself, oh, you're just limiting what you can do. But I hope to be able to show you that you can get as far as you need to, living along the lines of consistent values. What I've found out, and I'm going to talk about it a lot more on Sunday, is that we're a summation of the choices we make in life. At the end of the day, that's what it comes down to. Your life is a compendium of choices that you make at different points. Now, how you make those decisions, how you intentionally choose the path you want to follow, will shape your life. I'm going to share my life journey as a signpost of consistently making things through the lens of values, through the lens of excellence, through the lens of perseverance, of resilience, and perpetual optimism. So I'm looking forward to it. I hope you'll be able to join me. Let's have fun on Sunday.
You know, you are making me, Mr. Balogun, as if you say I should not end this. I said, my God, within 1 second or a few seconds, you have given us a whole sermon that we can actually close and go. You've talked about value-based life. Value-based life. So I caught it that you are going to be sharing what it takes to have a value-based life. That's serious. Then you talk about summation of choices we make in life. Everything we are is about summation of choices that we make in life. Let me read a few comments of people right now before we call it a good time of promotion and marketing. Lily Ochengi. Lily Ochengi say, hello, mommy. Good to see Mr. Balogun. Looking forward to Sunday. Another fellow is saying about the testimony people gave about you, a man of character, a man of excellence. They are saying very true. Another fellow said true. Another fellow says, good to know there is a lot of space up there. No space for backstop. Our father owns cattle on a thousand hills. All right. Yes. This fellow, you are saying that truly we have a lot of space up. We don't know why people are fighting downstairs here. Somebody says, Catherine, tune in. Another fellow is, they are clapping and cheering. Somebody else says, Vicky say, our life is a compendium of the choices we make in life based on the values we choose. So now this fellow has brought your two sentences and given us a powerful statement. Christine is saying, let RCCG Solution Center Building Committee regular updates, clear, concise points, and thinking gentleman.
Is it that, the audience is very generous. They're very generous with their.
No, they're not generous. They keep it real here. It's like when they keep it real. They will say exactly what they know. They are not generous. They are saying what it is. And if we dispute it, we have the right to say no. Because say so, what he's saying here, he said, this fellow Christian is saying, you were asking for regular updates. That's you, I know.
Yes.
And those regular updates must be clear. No beating about the bush. That's you, I know. And the points must be concise. That's you, I believe you are. So they are not generous. They are keeping it real. Perry said, looking forward to hear now how to get to that top. Jumoke Saibe said, looking forward to Sunday. Jumoke Saibe and the husband are expatriates in Kenya, and they are part of the ministerial team in RCCG Solution Center, and God is using them tremendously. Excellent. They are looking forward to the meeting. Somebody is saying, I'm looking forward to hearing more on Sunday. So this is just to let you know that people are already waiting. People are already waiting. They didn't know that we'll be on right now. They didn't know we'd be on. I just said, let me go on. And they're already there. That tells you the audience that will be expecting us on Sunday. So thank you so much, Balogun. You have given us the light now to direct us. You have given us the North Pole to navigate through this show by talking about value-based lifestyle. And choices that we make in life. So thank you so much for those few words that have opened the floodgate for Sunday. We'll be expecting you. We'll begin a bit earlier than 8 o'clock. Our fans, make sure to tune in, because you remember we normally struggle with time. Closing. Some of you are texting, don't close. Don't stop that show. But we have to stop it. So I want you to log in with us. We'll be beginning few minutes before 8, so that we interact with you guys before, when once it's 8 o'clock, we hit the road. Yeah, no, we are starting before 8, but before, by when it is 8, so that nobody accuses me that I started before 8 and log them out. Yeah, then we log in before 8, we'll be live before 8, say 10 minutes before 8, we'll be live as we interact with the comments. Because there are people who want to welcome you, they know you, we want to mention their name all over the globe. Then when it is 8, we start asking you those serious questions so that nobody misses out. Centrine Nafula is saying, I'm looking forward. She works with Safaricom and she's doing well in that place. So she says she's looking forward to seeing us on Sunday. Thank you so much, Mr. Balogu.
No, thank you. I'm really looking forward to it. And let's let the learning be both ways. You know, I want to interact with the audience and learn from them as well. Thank you.
All right. Somebody is saying, Mommy, do you think you need to change this thing from 1 hour to 1 and 1.5 hours? Somebody is telling me, why don't you change this thing to 1.5 hours instead of 1 hour? Anyway, just keep following us. We will keep it real. You know, when you keep it real, it's a realistic life. It can be 1 hour, it can be 2 hours. That is keeping it real because life is not stereotype. Life, something, we are not static. We move. Whether you know it or not, whether you want it or not, whether you like it or not, life is moving. The art is moving. So even if you refuse to move, you are moving by force. Everything is moving. So we keep it real. If we shoot, overshoot 1 hour, no problem. If we stop in 1 hour, no problem. The most important thing is let's keep it real on Sunday. Thank you so much. I see all of you on Sunday. God bless you.
Thank you.
All right.